My name is Lucas, and I'm an engineer on Google Web Designer. In this video, I will show how to use events with groups. I'm starting with a simple document that has two images and a button where, when pressed, it hides the left-hand image. I'll demonstrate this in the browser. I click on the button, and the image disappears. I can now select these elements and convert them to a group. Because all of the elements that participate in the event, the target, which is the button, and the receiver, which is this left-hand image, because they are all inside the group, the event is now owned by the group. And that means that if I drag new instances on stage, then they also have the same event. So if I preview in a browser, here's one instance, and here's the other. I can edit the group to add additional events. So I'll start by creating a new button by copying and pasting the original. And I'll change its name. I'll assign it an ID in the property inspector. And finally, I will go to the events dialog, and I will say that when we click on this, we set the opacity of the right teapot to 0. Okay, and if I preview this in the browser, I get the expected behavior. So far, we've added events that are inside of a group, but can we have an event that targets just a particular instance of the group? Well, to start, I'll create an additional button. I'm going to call this Show All Teapots. Make it a little easier to see by giving it a background color. And I will assign it an ID. I'll call it New Button. Okay. Now, for an element to participate in an event, it has to have a unique ID. Well, the button has an ID. And the elements in this instance have IDs. Here, this image is called left teapot, and here it's called right teapot. However, these IDs are not unique because instances are identical for all instances of the same group. And if I go to the other instance, I see that this is also called left teapot, and this is also called right teapot. So to have a unique way of identifying the elements in this instance, I have to also give the instance an ID. So I'm going to call it right instance. And with that, I can now go to the events dialog and say if I click, and here we see the elements in that right-hand instance. We do not see the elements in the left instance because I never gave it an ID. So I select the left teapot, I set its opacity to 1, and then finally I add an additional event that sets the opacity of the other teapot to 1. And finally, if I preview in the browser, everything works as intended. That concludes this introduction to using events with groups. Thank you for watching.